Well, before I even start, you know, I just wanted to say, like, it's an honor to be up here. You know, I had the opportunity to be nominated to, you know, to represent all of you. But without further ado, I'm just going to start. So my name is Diego Ramirez, for those who don't know me. I study electrical power engineering technology. And my relationship with Chef has been, like, really, really, really long for all those who do personally know me. And it all started about 6 years ago when my older brother introduced me to Chef by taking me out to a guy's night out. And ever since then, you know, that's always changed my mentality in high school. I've always wanted to be part of Chef. And so whenever I did enroll into college, I became part of the new member executive board. And then from there, I transitioned to become the outreach chair. And throughout my outreach chair opportunities, you know, I brought a lot of new initiatives into the table. I've had the opportunity to represent Chef in different aspects and different competitions. And, you know, it was nice to win awards on behalf of Chef as well. And so now as I'm transitioning into a higher position, I wanted to talk about what, you know, what I've seen throughout the last 6 years, and that's how the presidents have changed from Cindy starting off all the way to Vanessa right now. And what I've noticed is that as times change, our chapter changes and we develop into a more complicated system. And as we progress, we become a multifaceted organization and we involve more people from different colleges and different backgrounds, we have to solve different problems that arise. And so what I've noticed and what I would like to bring to the table is, you know, our professional development. And the way I've noticed by doing that is that a lot of us come out to these meetings and we're not necessarily too interested in these companies. And that's a problem, because if you're not interested in a company, then you're not going to apply. And if you don't apply, then how are you going to get a job? So with that being said, I heard from a previous president is that the best leaders are not necessarily someone who serves themselves, but rather someone who serves their followers. And what I want to bring is serving y'all and seeing what y'all would be interested in doing. And the way I'd like to do this is by introducing surveys that just show where you want us to go to, what market are y'all interested in, so we can have these companies come out and see y'all for the people who you really are and hire you for the jobs that you want. And another thing that I wanted to add is that, you know, we have a sort of system where we just kind of determine you by your major, but not necessarily determined by your experience. And I feel like that's what companies really like to hear. Because it's okay if we're 80% Mechies, but if we have aerospace people, computer science people, and they have experience within these different markets, and we can show that in percentages, then they're more transparent with us, and they'll see, like, oh, okay, they might be kind of unbalanced when it comes to their membership, but they have the experience, and they have the game changers, like I know that y'all are. And so my last initiative that I really want to introduce was the fact that we go through different methods of finding funding. I know previously we relied on certain companies or we relied on certain colleges, but we're no longer the same thing we were 5 or 6 years ago, you know? So we need to focus on new, unconventional methods of receiving funds, whether it's talking to local organizations that promote nonprofit organizations, whether it's talking to different colleges, because we're no longer just engineers. Now we're technicians. Now we're computer science majors. Now we're natural science majors. And so we can talk to these different colleges to receive different funding. So going all back to this, you know, I've always seen it like a dynasty. And not necessarily because my older brother was a president, but because the people in front of me, I saw them as older brothers and older sisters. And hopefully they can transition and give me the opportunity to do what's best for my family, because I see all of you as extended members of my family. So with that being said, guys, I appreciate your time and attention. Hope to see you at the poll soon.
President, obviously being one of the biggest chapters in the nation, a lot of people look at everything we do. So how do you plan to keep that executive presence that you portrayed here on your social media all throughout?
The most important thing that I noticed that you did during your presentation was these hashtags. They're super crucial, because these hashtags, sometimes I just hashtag Region 5 sometimes I hashtag 5 in general, and Region 5 will appear because it's within that catalog of hashtags. And so being able to continue implementing that is what I think it's something that's kind of drifted away from the last, you know, year or so, maybe two. Because everyone uses social media, everyone's always picking our hashtags to kind of look for memes, but sometimes we end up finding Chef, and sometimes we end up being motivated, or sometimes companies end up seeing that, because we sometimes share hashtags with other companies, and whenever recruiters are like, oh, you know, hashtag Houston Diversity or Houston STEM, boom, we show up as well. And so that's what I kind of would like to see a little bit more of, you know, telling y'all, because y'all are members, y'all represent us just as we represent you, to go ahead and just add a little hashtag on your post, because I know y'all love posting, and so there's no reason why we shouldn't, you know, continue using these hashtags.
What I meant was to keep that executive presence, not necessarily share on social media. It was more like, you stand here today and you have this presence. How do you translate that on your social media?
Okay, I see. Well, by showing better quality stuff, to be honest with you, a lot of companies at first, they kind of like, oh, they have a ton of members. Let's go ahead and like dig into that. But rather than just highlighting all the members we have, because we are one of the largest chapters in the nation, we should highlight, as we've been doing, you know, how our research has been going, how our internships have been going, because that shows and highlights our expertise and our prowess rather than how big we are. And that shows an executive presence, because we want people who are good at what they do, and we want people who are changing the game as they progress throughout their, you know, collegiate and professional careers. And I feel like that would be a great way to show our executive presence.
So the moment that we are announced that we become presidents, right, at banquet, we feel very ambitious and we feel like we can change everything because we have this vision. But in reality, we are missing key elements and the knowledge to make strategic decisions that would better the chapter. How do you deal with the presence of all these past presidents and then telling you different stuff? So it's more of like the pressure.
Going back to what you just said, I've had that whenever I was outreach chair. I had we started a scholarship. I don't know if you can get any more ambitious when it comes to outreach and impacting the community than legitimately giving them an opportunity to make and pursue a career in STEM by financially backing them. And so what I've noticed a lot is that you hear a lot more no's than you hear yeses, and that's perfectly fine. But what matters is learning from the no's so you can produce more yeses. And so when it comes to that, you know, I have a lot of ideas, I have a lot of ambitions, and I've seen different presidents go throughout different routes on how to do it. You know, and it's unfortunate, but we fail a lot. And personally, I've learned more from my failures than from my successes. And I feel like going back and kind of getting that wisdom on how to improve can definitely make the impact that we need, especially now that we're changing and becoming a very diverse organization. So,
yeah. All right. But that means that what would be the one pillar you would like to focus on the most?
Ooh, that's a tough one. I wish I could give you like the basic answer, be like all of them. But no, I think the one that I would really want to focus is academics. And this is just me personally. You know, everyone can tell, I don't have an amazing GPA, but I have a fighting spirit. I feel like I've gone out and I've had about, give or take, anywhere between 6 to 9 interviews in the last year, and it just hurts a lot whenever they tell you no because of your GPA. And now that I know, now that I've landed something, now that I've increased it, you know, I would like to tell like upcoming members, like, yes, your GPA is your foundation. And from that foundation, you can come be part of us, and we'll give you the platform to jump onto what you want to do to succeed. And I wish these papers had a delta, like, of GPA, because I can guarantee you, within this year, where I'm stepping at right now, this time period, where I was last year, I made about a 0.5 jump in my GPA. So I'd like to tell members, like, we can focus, and if you put the hard work, we're more than happy to give you the opportunity to advance.
Questions from the audience, Cindy? So I don't know if you guys have heard, but Chef and Maya is planning on merging together. Let's say you're together as president, and Maya and Chef do merge within the year, because that's still in the year. How do you feel about that, and what would be your first priority with the merging of
the lives? So, how do I feel about it personally? Well, Chef has always been introducing more and more people into it. So what's wrong with introducing another organization to be part of us now? So they're just an extended version of our family. But my first priority, though, was whenever you have new members in your family, you kind of have to organize yourself on how everything's going to work within your household. So I feel like the most important first step would be, how is our executive board going to work from here on in, and where is our pockets going to go to? Because, you know, we need financial backing in order to continue doing our great projects, continue bringing y'all out to Chef National, and continue, you know, doing these events that make us number one in the nation. So with that being said, you know, it's always important to make sure that Maya's will, or hopefully be incorporated into us so we can continue being number one.
All right, so this goes back a little bit to what you said earlier about, you know, the whole dynasty thing, that, I guess, whole idea. So images, you know, our image on a national stage is a really big deal, and that starts from the top down, right? So how do you as president plan on maintaining or improving the image of the chapter on a national scale, whether it's, you know, between other chapters in the region or just between other chapters nationally?
Well, between other chapters in the region, I know Chef UH is very well intertwined with almost every other major chef chapter in Texas, but I feel like a crucial point in our development is the SROs, because when we're doing that, we have an opportunity to interact with other chapters, and in doing so, they kind of take notes from us because we're almost like the big brother to them. And so if we're able to, you know, record that and take advantage of these opportunities, that allows us to show that our chapter is not just good, but we're mentors as well to these other smaller chapters, especially like ACC. I know Mario comes out a lot and he wants to learn more about developing a chapter in ACC. They're going through the works right now. I know Prairie View A&M has come out to several events and they kind of want to talk to us. And I feel like if we're able to highlight that and like to national members, like when it comes to like their board and when they decide who is like the best chapter of the year, I feel like that will definitely make us stand out more, because you can't possibly be better than your teacher because he's teaching you, you know what I'm saying? Well, you can, but what I mean to say is that you notice a mentor a lot quicker than the mentee until the mentee surpasses him. So right now that we're the mentor, we definitely want to teach them, our mentees, which are other chapters, to one day hopefully reach us, if not surpass us. Because we all know right now, WH has, it's a powerhouse. Like, no, like, we're like, it's like, for those who watch soccer, it's like Bayern Munich, everyone else. Like, it's ridiculous. It's a 19-point difference. Like, you're not going to reach that. But if we're able to up and rise the competition and make it more like a Barclays, so more people can see and they're more aware of how competitive Hispanics can be and those in chef can be, then that's it makes it more a better league, sort of say.